feet.
And meanwhile, the Crow River is also experiencing unusually high levels and is above flood stage. NOAA says today it reached 18.8 feet. They expect it to crest tomorrow night at more than 20 feet. Our Josh Rosenthal is live in Delano talking to people about the water that is just everywhere there, Josh.
Tom, I'm on the aptly named River Street here in Delano, and behind this giant makeshift clay wall, you've got Three Crows Cafe and Coffee House. Behind that, you've got the Crow River. This place is kind of like an institution out here. As a result, every time the Crow River rises, so do the number of hands of people volunteering to help out.
It's the Crow River versus the Three Crows. And an army of volunteers.
We need some more YDM, young dumb muscle.
They've been at it since 9 o'clock Friday night. Fill a sandbag or two, have a conversation or three.
This is like the Cheers bar, you know, you walk in and they go, "Norm!"
Fact is, these people don't have to do this. They want to. There's a real sense of community here. It's a rare positive side effect of really lousy weather.
Does everybody know everybody?
Yep. Absolutely. Well, there's a couple YDMs right there I don't know, but
actually, some kids just showed up. Yay, because, you know, we're all kind of old.
Gina Coburn owns the place. She says it's flooded 3 times in 10 years. Every single time, huge groups of people come out to help.
I don't know. Maybe it's a Delano thing to do. I'm not sure. It's wonderful.
And it's not easy. The basement here will flood. That means people will watch the pumps all night long.
So if you're not doing anything in the middle of the night, we got a job for you.
Fact is, there might not be any job openings. Put simply, Minnesotans know bad weather and how to make the most of it.
All of us feel like we will do anything we can to preserve the Three Crows. Long live the Three Crows.
All right, I've got one more story for you. It turns out the Three Crows had a lot of reservations for tonight. Obviously, they can't serve people food here tonight. So Gina, the owner, called everybody with a reservation and invited them to her house for a barbecue. So she's got to worry about this place flooding, and she's got to worry about serving a whole bunch of people food at her home. Gina, we wish you a whole lot of luck. Reporting live in Delano, Josh Rosenthal, 508.